it's me again, Kirsty McKean from Nao Nails. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do another My Little Pony design, and today we're going to do Fluttershy. On this nail that I've already created, I've already sculpted out a stiletto nail, and I've used warm beige for this. It's ready for application of a bit of gel polish, and we're using Pin It, which is a gorgeous pink. I'm going to cover this nail, the whole nail, in this gorgeous pink. Wow, I think we're getting away with one coat of that. Awesome coverage. Pop that into the lamp. I'm going to use a little bit of raspberry sparkle glitter dust. And I'm going to take a dry brush, she says, and pop a little bit up that corner, and a little bit on the tip. I'm going to seal that with top and base. It's just going to add a bit of sparkle into the background. Cure that into the lamp. Now that's cured, I'm going to take off the sticky layer, and then we're going to create a 3D My Little Pony. Before I apply the 3D, I'm still going to map out where it's going to go. So I just need a little bit of white paint that's really watered down. Because it's on a smooth surface, you can literally scratch off anything that you don't want. So if you make a mistake or anything like that. What we're going to do first is we're going to do the hair first, because we've got to work a little bit backwards. I feel like I'm working backwards. So we're going to lay the hair down, and then we'll put the face in. So I'm going to do this mane here first. Then I'll do the face, and then I'll come and do this part here. And then we're going to add a wing to the side. So we've got some acrylic powders. We've got cotton candy, metallic rose, soft pastel pink, beryl, and soft pastel lemon. So we're going to do the hair first. I've not done a 3D My Little Pony before, so this is completely trial and error. Hopefully it goes right and it's not so much error. Small beads. Tickle it into the place that you want. I'm actually going to start at the top here. You can see I'm overlapping these colours just to give it a bit more texture, really, and interest. So I'm just overlapping the pinks. Quite small beads. So that's that part of her hair done. I'm going to come round here underneath her face a little bit. Right, so the two yellows that I've got, first of all, I'm going to put a thin layer of the colour that's called Beryl down. Mainly towards the edge of where her face is going to be. My Little Pony. I've just had the thingy in my head. The new one. The new one that the kids have drilled into my brain. I'm using a bigger brush now because that was a bigger bead. For her face. I And we're going to take some up for her ear and her neck. Going to use this smaller brush to make sure it's exactly where I want it and how I want it. Going to do a little bit of an indentation there for her jaw and the ear. Don't forget her nose. Just building a little bit of height with that bead. I'm just going to press into that to open the ear up a little bit. And then we're going to do this, the rest of the mane coming down here. I'm going to start at this curved point here. That colour, and then carry on with that colour up here. So we get like a continuation of the colour. We're going to layer it again. So I'm going to do the same again and layer those colours. Going to do her eye, which is a lovely big eye that they can see to the ends of the world. I want it to be nice and smooth, so I'm going to go into the liquid and just smooth it off with the liquid. So I'm going to paint onto that. Oh, I've just thought I need to add a little bit of tiny bit of that pastel yellow to create a bit of definition for that sort of snouty thing. So we've got a little bit of a smile there, and now they're quite simple wings, aren't they? So I'm going to use that backing just to do quite basic shimples, a simple wing. Just putting a little bit of that glitter towards that centre bit, and then I'm going to do another layer of wingy things, whatever they are. So it's going to come out the nail like that. Peel it off the backing, a little bit of nail glue, and what I'm going to do is add some yellow acrylic bright in that little tiny crack, I suppose, where it attaches. I'm going to put another one of these sort of feather kind of shapes, I suppose they are, for the wing. Very simple shapes, don't forget this is a cartoon character. This might not be very wearable, however, Lauren has actually wore some crazy stuff, so she probably could wear it. But I just want to show you what you can do. We can take it one step further. Maybe it's one step too far. There we go. I'm going to paint the eye now. Now, because it's acrylic, it will suck up the paint. And I'm going to do the blue part of the eye. Thinking that the water's a cup of tea, but it's not, it's water. However, I've done that before, you know, I've dipped my brush in my tea. You know, like when I've been doing competitions and my head's been like in it for hours and I've gone to my tea and thought, oh dear. I've still drank it, to be fair. I couldn't be bothered to get back up and make another one. So there's the eye, and then we're going to put the shine on the eye. So the reflection, the white reflection. There's a little bit of white paint. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use Mega Gloss on the eye, on the actual eye. But I'm going to have to do it quite carefully, so I'm just going to put a little bit on my palette. I'm going to do it with a dotting tool, just because it can be a little bit more controlled. Because I want the eye to be shiny. I don't want anything else to be shiny though, just the eye. Pop that into the lamp and cure, and then the rest of the paint that's on the acrylic, we're just going to put a little bit of glue onto that. I'm going to put some glue onto the back of the sculpting form and literally just pop that on exactly where that is, because I don't want the rest of it to go shiny. Just like that. So I'm just going to do a cutie spot up here, which is a very, very basic butterfly. So one bead, I'm just going to pull it to the centre a little bit like that. I'm going to pull one wing out, another wing out, and then another wing out, and then the other wing out. Just simple, that's how it is. It's nothing too difficult. Gonna use the glue again with the dotting tool, because this is a metal dotting tool. You can clean that up with some acetone, that'll just get the glue off that. So don't think, oh, I don't want to ruin my dotting tool. You can literally just get a wipe with some acetone on and just clean that off. All that's left to do is put a bit of cuticle oil on. And the reason, obviously, that I put the glue on top of the paint is to hold the paint on. If I didn't seal the paint with anything, then it would wash away. The glue will hold it on, it holds it on for a very long time as well. So a bit of cuticle oil. And that is Fluttershy, completely finished. All 3D work, little bit of paint. There you are, that's Fluttershy done for you in 3D acrylic. I hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to like this page and also subscribe, add some comments below. I'll try to get to you. I can't answer them all, but I will answer what I can. And don't forget to like us on Instagram and Facebook, and we'll see you next time. Bye bye.